Hello everyone, I'm Shweta Verma. I love to listen to audiobooks, so I decided to make my own audiobook using Python code. And here is the tutorial. It is a very simple tutorial. You just need to write 10 lines of code and you have to follow 4 steps. So let's get into it. First step is you have to have your IDLE with you, or your Python IDLE. If you don't have it, just go to any web browser and write Python download. And here is the official site of Python. You can go there and click on this download button. It will get downloaded shortly. And then second step is you have to have your editor with you. So I'm using PyCharm. You can use any editor you have. If you have VS Code or any other editor, you can use that. I'm comfortable with PyCharm, so I'm using PyCharm. PyCharm has these two variants with it. One is the professional one and second is the community version. And if you have money, then you can go with the professional, but I don't have money, so I'm going with the community version. You can click here this download button and it will get downloaded shortly according to your internet speed. After getting downloaded, you just have to open your PyCharm. Click on the icon you have on your desktop. It will get started. Okay, so it is starting. It is preparing some workspace, etc. Okay, so now you have to create your new project. Click on file and then click on new project. And it will give you many options, actually one option, and you can give your project a name. I'm giving it audiobook. You can give any name you want. I'm going with audiobook and just click on create. Okay, audiobook one. So it is creating again some virtual environment or something. You just wait, have some patience, it will get started shortly. Okay, so it started. You just have to clear this main.py. So select all and just backspace. Now the third step is you have to make your Python speak. For that you will need to install a module. So just click on the terminal. It will open shortly and write pip install pyttsx3. So 3 is the version and this is a module name, and just click enter. It will start downloading or installing whatever you need. See, collecting something. And after a few seconds, it will get completed. So just wait. Running some setup, successfully installed. Okay, after the successful installation, you just
have to write import. So import that module 6.3 and just press enter. And now you have to initialize a variable so that it can speak. I'm giving a name speaker. P-A-K-E-R. Speaker is equal to, you give the module name P-Y-T-T and dot initialize. Init matlab initialization and nothing. Okay, now next line is make your variable say something. So write speaker dot say and write anything you want. I'm writing I am Shweta Verma and I want to be a developer. I want to be a developer. Okay, fine. Now just one more line. Just we need to write speaker dot see, run and wait. Nothing.
And these four lines are complete and we need to run this code now. So click here, a play button or run button, whatever. And
I am Swita Varma. I want to be a developer.
See, our Python is ready to speak now. Now we will make it read something and we need to read some PDF. As I mentioned already, we just have to then download the book PDF and replace the name that I will give you. So for that we need to have one more module. So go to the terminal and write pip install. Next module is write pypdf2. So its version is 2 and pypdf. So it's collecting something and
this time it's fast. Okay, fine. So and for that you need to download a PDF also, right? So just copy this address or copy this path, copy path, click on the absolute path and copy it and download your PDF wherever you want. See, I have already downloaded this one, Python tutorial, and actually I went to this browser and write Python PDF. You can download any PDF or any book you want. I'm just going with a simple prototype. It is Python PDF and it here's the first link. It is a Python PDF from tutorial point. You can download whatever you want and any book or something. I'm just giving an example. So here's the PDF and click here on this download button and it will get downloaded in your downloads or whatever location you give. So after getting download, just here it is and I have already copied the path where is my project. So I'm just copy pasting this, enter. Here is my project and I have downloaded it here. So I'm just copying it, like I'm just copying it and I will paste here at the location of my project. So paste. Okay, fine. As you can see, it is here now. I have my
project and my PDF in the same folder. Okay, now I will open that PDF. For that, I'm initializing a variable name book. Book is equal to open. Open is an inbuilt function, so you need not to mention anything about it. And the PDF name, it is Python tutorial. Okay, the first option. And this, just for making sure that it will get read in binary format, I'm writing RB. Okay, so it is done right now and now we will import our second module that we have installed. Import and the module name was pypdf2. Okay, fine. Now we will use that to read this book. So we will make a variable name pdf reader. Just to make it readable, I am capitalizing that R word and reader, and equal to, we will give the name of our module dot the variable name PDF reader and we will mention that book. Okay, after this line it will read that book and it will get stored in this PDF reader. After this we want to have all the number of pages, so we will make a variable name pages equal to PDF reader reader dot num pages, the second one. And just to make sure it is in it, so I will print it. Print pages. And we will run it to just check.
I am Swita Verma.
I'm Shweta Verma. Okay, just shut up. Okay, so print pages. So here are 512 pages. And just let's check it. Okay, fine. It has 512 pages. So it's properly working right now.
So the next step is we have to get pages into a variable. Just write page equal to PDF reader dot get pages, and we need to read from all these are just index or whatever table of content something, so we will read it from okay, finally it's getting started. We will read it from page number 15, but here is indexing from 1, but Python read it from 0, so we will read it from 14 and get page number 14. Okay, fine. And after this we need to extract the text. So text is equal to page dot extract, T-R-A-C-T, extract text. Okay, page dot extract text. Okay, fine. And we need to change it to text. Now we will run this program, and after running it I will go to that PDF and we will check it is reading line by line or not.
Python 3.x introduced some Python 2 incompatible keywords and features that can be imported via the in built __future__module in Python 2. It is recommended to use __future__imports. If you are planning Python 3.x,
if you want to stop
code,
it and for just example, stop it here. And so here's the audiobook ready. You can remove this line, print pages, because we don't need it. And so these are only 10 lines of code, and your audiobook is ready. So enjoy. And
okay, so our audiobook is ready now. And just make sure you like this video and subscribe to my channel for more content. Bye-bye.